Hi guys, welcome to Gatematic. In the previous lecture, we saw the introduction of PWM and what kind of PWM technique is done, why PWM technique is applied. These all things, that is the basic of PWM, we saw in the previous lecture. Now in this lecture, we will start a multiple PWM technique. So let's get started. So this is my output voltage we got in multiple PWM technique, and how we can generate this output voltage that I have already explained you in the previous lecture, that is the lecture number 40. From 0 to pi you can see the pulse width is 2d. I already defined that the 2d is equal to the pulse width per half cycle. So each pulse width is having 2d upon n. These all concept I explained you in the previous lecture. This is my 2d upon n, where n is equal to 3. By taking this waveform. Okay, so this is my example of multiple PWM. So in multiple PWM technique, you can see here each pulse width is same, the space width are also equal. This is my space width, this is my space width, this is my space width, and this is my space width. So per half cycle we are getting 4 space width for n is equal to 3. Are you getting this? And gamma, let us denote this parameter. This is my gamma. Gamma is the angle from 0 to half of pulse width. Okay, this is my gamma. Are you getting this? So these all things you should know, because in order to derive the Fourier series expression, you need to know these things. So each pulse width is equal to 2d upon n. I know this. In the same way, I can say each space width. Space width is equal to this much. This much, and this much, and these are equal. So space width I can write, see here, this is my gamma, right? And half of the pulse width I can easily say d by n is the half of pulse width. So I can say gamma minus d by n will give me the each space width. So I can write gamma minus d by n. Now my aim is to find the value of this gamma. Okay, so how will I find? Let us understand here. For 3 pulse widths, we are getting 4 space widths. So I can say total space width will be equal to 4, and this 4 will be equal to n plus 1. See here, for 3 pulse widths, we are getting 4 space widths. That means I can write like n plus 1. Okay. Now what you can write till pi, see, 4 multiplied by gamma minus d by n. This is my total space width. Plus total pulse width will be 2d, 2d by n plus 2d by n plus 2d by n, that is equal to 6d by n. Put the value of n is equal to 3, you will get pulse width that is equal to 2d only. Okay, that is equal to pi. I can write like this. Now I can replace this 4 with n plus 1. I can replace like this, n plus 1 into gamma minus d by n. Plus per half cycle, I know the pulse width is 2d is equal to pi. So from here, I can easily get gamma that is equal to pi minus 2d upon n plus 1 plus d by n. This is really important. If you'll see the PS Bimra, you will not able to understand, because they derive the expression for by considering 2 pulse. Okay, and they give the general formula of gamma that is equal to this much. So you have to mug up. I have solved the problem of yours. What you can do, you can proceed like this in order to find the gamma that is equal to pi minus 2d by n plus 1 plus d by n, where n is the number of pulse. In this way we can find the value of gamma. Now the question arises that why we are finding the gamma, what is the benefit of finding the gamma, right? So let us understand that I need to find the Fourier series expression of this multiple pulse width modulation. So how will I find that? We are going to see. So first see, this function is half wave symmetry or not. Of course, this function is half wave symmetry. This is the mathematic part of Fourier series, and I will explain this in lecture number 42. Don't worry. Okay, till now just understand that half wave symmetry, the condition of half wave symmetry is f of theta is equal to minus of f of pi plus theta. Means if I will find the value at angle this theta, let us consider this is my angle theta. Okay, then pi plus theta will be somehow here. Okay, so minus of f of pi plus theta, it is satisfying. So this is my half wave symmetry, that is denoted as HWS. I will explain each and everything of Fourier series in lecture number 42. Don't worry, till now you should know that this is half wave symmetry. Okay. Also, this is odd function. So odd function plus half wave symmetry means this will give only Bn in Fourier series, and A0 and An will be equal to 0. So what is the value of Bn that we are going to find? So Bn will be equal to 2 upon 2 pi. It is having some limit, I don't want to explain now. And this is having peak voltage, that is equal to, let us say, VDC. And this is minus VDC. So this is equal to VDC into sine n omega t into d omega t, right? Now, how to take the limit? See, I am taking one cycle only. Okay, so if I will take one cycle, then this cycle is at from gamma minus d by n to gamma plus d by n. If I will consider these cycles, then the limit will be gamma minus d by n to gamma plus d by n. I can write like this. And this is the Bn of this pulse width, right? So if I need to find the Bn of total pulse width per half cycle, then what I need to do? I need to multiply by n. So this is the generalized expression of Bn. Are you getting this? Please understand each and every point so that you will not have any problem later on. Okay. So this is the Bn of each pulse width. And if I will multiply this with n, then I will get the Bn of total pulse width. Now, according to half wave symmetry, I know I need to multiply this by 2 also. If you are having any doubt in writing these things, then just wait for the next lecture, that is the lecture number 42. I will explain each and every concept. Up till now, you should note down how this is coming. Okay. Why I am multiplying this by 2? See, I am finding the Bn up to pi only. From pi to 2 pi, I am not finding. So from pi to 2 pi also, the Bn will remain same that we are getting from 0 to pi. That's why I am multiplying this by 2. Got it? These all concept I will explain you in application of Fourier series, that is the next lecture. Don't worry. Up till now, just understand how to find the value of Bn in Fourier series expression. So if I will find the value of Bn, then I can easily write V0 of t is equal to summation of n is equal to 135 up to infinite Bn sine n omega naught t. This is my total Fourier series expression, as we know that A0 and An will be equal to 0 for half wave symmetry. Also, for half wave symmetry, there is the one features of half wave symmetry that there will be no any even harmonics. Okay, so mug up these things. I will explain you in lecture number 42 that there will be no any even harmonics present in half wave symmetry. So this is my Fourier expression of Bn. Now solve this expression, it will be equal to cos n gamma minus d by n minus cos n gamma plus d by n. Now do mathematics, it will be equal to 2n vdc upon n pi. Now you can manipulate this cos a minus b. So it will be cos a cos b plus sin a sin b, and cos a plus b, it is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So if you will do this, then cos n gamma and cos n d by n will get cancelled out. Overall, you will get 2 sin n gamma into sin n d by n. 2 will come out outside. It will be equal to n multiplied by 4 vdc upon n pi sin n gamma into sin n d by n. This is my peak value of fundamental output voltage, that is also denoted as V01 of peak. Okay, so Bn is nothing but V01 of n, and here capital N is the number of pulse per half cycle and a small n is the harmonic number. Got it? So what is the final Fourier series expression of this kind of waveform? This kind of waveform is having final Fourier series expression, and this is my generalized expression. For any value of n, you can apply this Fourier series, that is equal to n multiplied by summation of n is equal to 135 up to infinite 4 vdc upon n pi sin n gamma sin n d by capital N. So this is the generalized expression of multiple PWM technique. This is my analysis, and I derived this just by generalizing each and every term in order to get the Fourier series expression of multiple PWM. Now if you want to take 2 pulse, no problem, take n is equal to 2, write down the Fourier series expression. If you want to take 1 pulse, no problem, take n is equal to 1 and write down the Fourier series expression. So is it necessary that I need to explain the single PWM technique? What is single PWM technique? that I already explained you in the previous lecture. That is the point number one. This is my single PWM technique. Here, one pulse width per half cycle. Okay, so what is the value of n? The value of n will be equal to 1. So for single PWM technique, I am omitting this. For single PWM technique, the value of n will be equal to 1. Now tell me, what is the value of gamma? Gamma will be equal to pi minus 2d upon n plus 1 plus d by n, right? Put n is equal to 1, it will be equal to pi by 2 minus d plus d. So gamma will come out to be pi by 2. So what is the Fourier series expression? V naught of t will be equal to, put capital N is equal to 1 in this expression, it will be equal to summation of n is equal to 135 up to infinite 4 vdc upon n pi sin n gamma. Here gamma is pi by 2, that means sin n pi by 2, we know that is equal to 1, and sin n d, so this will be equal to sin n d. That's all. So in each and every book you will see they have derived the Fourier series expression of single PWM, but they haven't derived the Fourier series expression of multiple PWM. If you know the Fourier series expression of multiple PWM, then do you need to mug up the Fourier series expression of single PWM? No, I don't think so. Just you need to put the value of n, and based on that you can find each and every parameter. Got it? So you need to understand this, how this is coming. I already explained you in this lecture how this is coming, and you need to understand why we are finding the gamma. Got it? That is the reason I explained the concept of multi PWM first, and then I told you that in single PWM only you need to put the value of n is equal to 1 to get the Fourier series expression of single PWM. And this is really important from gate point of view. This is not important for multiple PWM technique, is not important from gate point of view, but still I don't want to left any topic from inverter, because I already told you that in gate 18 they have not asked the questions from inverter, so definitely they are going to ask the questions from inverter in gate 2019. That's why I'm not skipping any point. Got it? Now you need to find the Fourier series expression of this. Let us consider the two pulse, and this is the equal width pulse, okay, separated by equal distance. This is my two pulse, means here n is equal to 2. So you can write the Fourier series expression for two pulse PWM also, that is equal to. So this is the Fourier series expression for two pulse PWM, right? In each half cycle we are getting two pulse. So this is my n is equal to 2, and this is my n is equal to 1. So in PS Vimra, or if you will see any book, then you will get the Fourier series expression of this two pulse converter like this, and they have explained by taking multiple PWM. So if any guy will go through the book and they will see the Fourier series expression of multiple PWM, that is equal to this much, then they will apply the formula, this formula, directly in multiple PWM. But this will be wrong. Why? Because this is only for two pulse per half cycle. If I will give you the questions for three pulse, then this formula is not valid. Are you getting this? So do not mug up these things, guys. I am again telling you, just see the generalized expression and see this expression. If you know this expression, then you can find the Fourier series expression of any kind of multiple PWM. Got it? Now the last concept I am going to explain, that is really important, so let us try to understand those concepts also. This is my output voltage Fourier series expression of single PWM. By taking n is equal to 1, and we found the gamma, that is equal to pi by 2. And this is my Fourier series expression of multiple PWM by taking n is equal to 2. If I will take n is equal to 3, then it will not valid. Now what is happening after multiple PWM? Why we are doing the multiple PWM or single PWM? See, output voltage V01 peak will be equal to what? See, V01 will be equal to 4 VDC upon n pi into sin nd for this, and for this V01 peak will be equal to sin pi by 3 minus d by 6 into sin nd by 2. Now what was the problem in single phase 180 degree mode that we have seen in the previous 5 to 6 lecture? The problem was that peak value of output voltage, or fundamental output voltage, we cannot control. It is fixed, that is equal to 4 VDC upon, so we cannot control this. Now see, after studying multiple PWM or single PWM, this is my single PWM, right? So for single PWM also, you can see the peak value of output voltage depending upon this D. Okay, and let us consider the pulse width that is equal to 72 degree. I am making the pulse width that is equal to 72 degree for both, so 2D will be equal to 72 degree for this also, so D will come out to be 36 degree, right? So here also D will be equal to 36 degree. So for D is equal to, for different value of D, the output voltage will be different. So we can vary the fundamental output voltage, or you can say we can control the fundamental output voltage. So this is the advantage of using the pulse width modulation, or by taking the multiple pulse, we can control the peak value of output voltage like this, because it is depending upon the pulse width. For n is equal to 1 and for n is equal to 2 also, I will take same pulse width and I will find the V01 peak. So see here what is happening. V01 peak, if you will take D is equal to 36 and here n is equal to 1, so it will be equal to sine D only, and take this n is equal to 1, so this will be equal to sine D by 2. Is it fine? So V01 peak will come out to be, that is equal to 4 VDC upon pi into sine 36, and this will come out to be V01 peak, that is equal to 8 VDC upon pi. So from here, what I am getting? I am getting V01 peak is equal to 0.7484 VDC, and here V01 peak I am getting, that is equal to 0.637 VDC. So here one more problem arises. What is the problem that we are going to discuss here? See, if I will increase the number of pulse, then peak value of fundamental output voltage decreases. See, this is 0.7486 for n is equal to 1, and for n is equal to 2, 0.637 VDC for same pulse width. So I can say peak value of fundamental output voltage is greater than peak value of fundamental output voltage for n is equal to 2. Now put n is equal to 3 also, you will find the peak value of fundamental output voltage will less than this much also. Got it? So what is the demerit of using the multiple PWM or PWM technique? Although we can remove the harmonics, but peak value of output voltage decreases if I will increase the number of pulse per half cycle. That means lower order harmonics are decreasing. Okay, so if lower order harmonics will decrease by increasing the number of pulse, then definitely the higher order harmonics will increase. So understand this concept, this is really important. What I am saying, if I will increase the number of pulse per half cycle, then V01 peak will decrease, and V01 peak is nothing but the lower order harmonic only, V01, V03, V05. So overall I can say lower order harmonics will decrease. So if lower order harmonics is decreases, and we know that the total current or total output voltage is fixed, that means higher order harmonics will increase. Understand this, this is really important. What I am doing, so let us say V0 of t is equal to Vm1 sine omega 1t plus Vm2, here odd harmonics will present, Vm3 sine 3 omega t plus Vm5 sine 5 omega t plus so on. Okay, this is my Fourier series expression, let us understand. Now as we increase the number of pulse, V01 peak will decrease, means this lower order harmonics is decreasing, means this will also decrease, this will also decrease. So overall lower order harmonics I am decreasing, and this V0 of t is fixed. Okay, so if V0 of t RMS value or peak value is fixed, and lower order harmonics is decreases because of increasing the number of pulse per half cycle, then definitely I can say the component which are present here, that is the higher order harmonics, that will increase. We are increasing the higher order harmonics and we are decreasing the lower order harmonics. Okay, and we know higher order harmonics can be easily filtered out by suitable filter. Okay, so by inserting suitable filter, that is the L filter, LC filter or LCL filter, we can reduce the higher order harmonics. It is very difficult to reduce the lower order harmonics. So what the multiple PWM technique do? Generally they lower the lower order harmonics and they increase the higher order harmonics, and because of that the peak value of fundamental output voltage we decreases. So although the peak value will decrease, but higher order harmonics we can easily eliminate by inserting suitable filter. So let us try to understand by FFT analysis. This is, let us say this is my V01 and this is my V03. this is my V05, okay, and so on. So this is my Fourier series expression of 180 degree mode. So here you can see the third harmonic is very difficult to eliminate. Why? Because if you will take the cutoff frequency at fundamental, then you can't able to decrease this, lower the amount of third harmonic. If you will, these all concepts are related to filter design, but I don't want to go in depth. Just understand that if you will draw the Bode plot and if you will see the, this is my cutoff frequency. So this is my filter and this will cut down like this. And third harmonic is somehow here. Okay, this is my third, this is my fundamental. Okay, so we cannot eliminate this third harmonic, we cannot eliminate this fifth harmonic, some portion of seventh harmonic we can eliminate. And from 9th harmonic, 11th harmonic, 13th harmonic, we can eliminate these all things by using suitable filter. This is my Bode plot of suitable filter. So third harmonic is very difficult to eliminate if the Fourier FFT will look like this. Now, in place of this, what the multiple PWM technique do? Multiple PWM technique are doing something like this. Let us understand. Overall, if I will increase the number of pulse, then V01 will decrease. And V03 will be very less, V05 will be very less, V07 will be very less, this is my V03, V05, this is very less, okay. But here, let us consider this is my 17, this is my 19, this is my 21, this is very high, okay. So this is what multiple PWM technique do. Although it decreases the peak value of output voltage, but it increases the low higher order harmonics. And if higher order harmonics is increases, then we can easily filter out the higher order harmonics by using suitable filter. Let us consider I am setting the cutoff frequency at fundamental. So Bode plot, if you will draw this, then it will be something like this. So after this, all the harmonics can be eliminated, right? So it is very easy. By inserting the filter, we can remove the higher order harmonics. So this is the advantage. And disadvantage is peak value of fundamental output voltage will decrease. However, this is not the disadvantage. We can increase the value of VDC, that is the supply voltage, in order to get the maximum peak voltage. This is not the disadvantage, but still you can say that this is a demerit, okay, by using multiple PWM technique. Although we can increase the higher order harmonics, this is the advantage, but peak value of fundamental output voltage will decrease. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is, in multiple PWM technique, or you can say in pulse width modulation, we can eliminate the lower order harmonics, or you can say we can decrease the lower order harmonics and increase the higher order harmonics. Are you getting this? This is really important. Most of the guys will say that lower order harmonics we cannot decrease, but by using PWM we can decrease the lower order harmonics, but the problem is higher order harmonics will increase. And to remove those higher order harmonics, suitable filter we can insert and we can remove those higher order harmonics. So in this way we can reduce the THD. So this is the complete knowledge of multiple PWM. What you need to remember, that I am going to explain you, that is first the generalized expression, Fourier series expression of multiple PWM, and by using this, put n is equal to 1, you will get gamma is equal to pi by 2, and this is really important for gate, that is the single PWM technique. Now take a single PWM technique, you can vary this pulse width. Let us take pulse width is equal to 2d. Based on that, you can find the V01 peak, V01 RMS, total RMS output voltage. Okay, so based on that, you can easily eliminate the third harmonic and fifth harmonic. Now, in order to eliminate the third harmonic, let us consider that I am taking the single pulse width modulation. Okay, so in single pulse width modulation, I know that RMS output voltage will be something like this. This is my output voltage having pulse width that is equal to 2d. So V0 RMS will be equal to VDC under root 2d upon pi. Okay. And V01 peak I can easily get from Fourier series expression, that is equal to 4 VDC upon pi into sin d. You need to remove the third harmonic, okay. So to remove the third harmonic, what you will do? You will just put V03 equal to 0. So V03 I can easily get here, sin n omega naught t will also come in Fourier series expression. It will be equal to 4 VDC upon 3 pi into sin 3d is equal to 0. So I can say 3d is equal to pi. So d will come out to be, that is equal to pi by 3, that is equal to 60 degree. So if I will make the pulse width 2d is equal to 120 degree, then in that case we cannot get the third harmonic. So in this way we can eliminate the third harmonic. In the same procedure we can eliminate the fifth harmonic also. Okay, only you need to put the sign 5d is equal to 0. So d will come out to be pi by 5. So 2d pulse width will be equal to 2 pi by 5. So these type of problem may be framed from the in the gate exam. So you should understand the single PWM technique in detail, and in multiple PWM technique I already derive you the Fourier series expression of multiple PWM technique. Got it? So this much concept you need to understand in multiple PWM technique and single PWM technique. Based on what we have studied now, let us take one homework. A single phase full bridge inverter is controlled by single PWM technique, fine, having pulse width that is given, that is equal to 120. You need to find the THD of output voltage, and second is how much THD is reduced as compared to 180 degree mode. 180 degree mode is nothing but what we saw in the previous 5 to 6 lecture. This is my 180 degree mode. So how much THD is reduced as compared to 180 degree mode? You have to find this, and first you need to find that is the THD of average output voltage. So take these two questions and write down your answer in the YouTube comment. If someone will say to explain this question, then I will explain this question in the next lecture. Got it? So that's all about this lecture. In the next lecture, that is the Fourier series of unequal PWM. This is really important. So if you are preparing for gate exam, then you should watch this lecture. I will explain how to apply the Fourier series, how to find the Fourier series of any kind of waveform in a quickest way. So wait for this lecture. In the coming lecture, we will discuss these all things. And this is really important lecture. Got it? If you guys understood the concept, then please like this video. And if you are having any doubt, then write down your query in the comment below or join our Facebook group for doubt solving.